And I'm gonna create some remote events. Or should I do remote functions? I don't know. I think I'm going to go with remote events. Nope, I am going to go with remote functions. So back and forth about this. Give control, and I'm really bad at naming these things. Give control and remove control? Sure. And so my bot system is going to fire those things. So when a player sits, I want to give control for this player's bot. And remove control when they get out from the seat. And then my client side controller here is going to handle that. So give control. That should hook it up. And we have to do this when we are playing with filtering enabled. You have to use things like this to communicate between servers and clients. Going to change the camera type when they are given control of the bot. I'm also going to add some body movement things in here. One will be, there's going to be three. So I'm going to have body position for hovering. I'm going to have body gyro for orientation. And I'm going to have body velocity for moving. All right. So my hover thing, the max force, will only have the ability to manipulate on the y-axis. That way, it's not going to be locking your position anywhere when you're moving around on the flat plane. It will only manipulate your y-axis. All right. So every 0.1 seconds, I'll update the movement of the bot. Let's hover 5 studs above the ground, I guess. All right. So to figure out where I need to hover exactly, I'm going to cast a ray downward to the ground, and I'm going to get the ground's position and then add hover height to it, and that's what my y value for hover will be for position. So I have array, ignore table, and train. So what I'm doing here is restricting y value. So I'm saying if it's less than 0, then set it to 0, else just keep it as y. So in other words, just keep y above or equal to 0. That way, if you go off a cliff or something, you don't just fall to your death. Which maybe I want to have happen, but for now, it's just fine. So that should set my hover position. Let's set our gyro and set move. This is easier just when you give a speed. What should my speed be? Just keep it 80 for now. So move.velocity equals main.superman.look vector times I don't know speed. I do know. Gyro, I'm gonna make look better in a minute, but for now, gyro.cframe equals mouse.hit. Should do it. When I'm done down here, I should set those values. reset them. Kind of like it's shutting down or something. And let's try it. So right now it should just automatically move forward toward my mouse. And it doesn't. So line 35, the first argument expected a vector 3 and it got a number. So line 35. Should do it. And look at that, it it kind of works. It goes sideways. So how about we rotate this? Like so. There we go. Oh my. It works. You can see that much at least. Let's see if it can go up a wedge part. Yep, kind of. Not very well, but it certainly tries to. Almost there. So I'm going up this hill, it doesn't seem to be resetting my hover position at all. So something's not working right. Oh, I know what it is. This needs to be my position.